Police had the Golden State Killer's DNA profile, but could not match it with any criminal already in the database. To mitigate this challenge, investigators used an open-source genealogy service called GEDmatch in an attempt to locate similar DNA records from the thousands of people on the website. Luckily for the investigators, a partial match to the Golden State Killer's DNA was found. They had managed to find a relative of the killer. From here, once a match is identified, experts can reverse engineer the suspect's family tree to find a pool of suspects that meet the description of the killer. After identifying relatives of Joseph D'Angelo, the police were able to narrow their search down to a single family instead of millions of random people. Detectives were able to hone in on Joseph through traditional investigative techniques, comparing descriptions from witnesses with people in the family of interest. Finally, D'Angelo, at 72 years of age, was arrested just miles from the location where many of the attacks took place. Forensic genealogy is a very hot topic in investigation right now. It's actually quite controversial because it raises ethical questions about DNA privacy and individual consent. Advocates for privacy question forensic genealogy as they feel it turns family members into genetic informants without their knowledge or consent. It's probably safe to say that most people who submit their DNA to commercial DNA testing services don't think their DNA will be used by law enforcement. Regardless of the potential controversy of this technique, it's hard to argue that it has not made waves in the forensics community.